Hey folks, welcome to Vibes History. Today we are going to listen to one of the most incredible and unique vibraphonists, Mr. Walt Dickerson. To hear him play, it is immediately clear what a unique and singular voice he was. And the track we're going to listen to today is from his second album called A Sense of Direction. This was released in 1962, and it is a song called Good Earth. But before we listen to it, I feel like it's helpful to know a little bit about Walt Dickerson. So, Walt Dickerson was born in 1928 in Philadelphia, and he died at the age of 80 in 2008. Here's an excerpt from an interview, which I will link also in the description. So, you're from Philadelphia. Philadelphia, yes, place of birth. And you were born, obviously. I don't really adhere to dates. To get caught up in the chronological aspect of things over a period of time can have a detrimental effect on the mind and the body, thinking in such a restricted area as the chronological factor or that mode. Since yesterday and tomorrow are today on the space timeline of infinity, that helps me to remain free and unfettered. So that's my response to when. So, let's listen to some Walt Dickerson. Okay, where to begin? There's a lot of amazing stuff in the notes that he plays, but you'd be missing a lot of the point to just transcribe those phrases and try to recite them back to me. I think there are some musicians who, for whatever reason, however they do it, they have this sort of spiritual undertone to what they play, and just this conviction that is so strong that you know that they are doing something that is really true to themselves and unique, and it's not copyable. You can't copy it. Walt Dickerson, everything about the man was so deliberate, so well thought out, so on purpose and for a reason. The amount of effort that he would go to just to prepare the mallets. He would buy only a certain type of mallets, and then he would remove all the strings so that they went down to the rubber core, and then he would soak them in some strange solution for a long time to get the perfect amount of bounciness and yet be able to play it very lightly. He would turn his vibraphone around and practice backwards for hours. He would do this. This is the kind of person Walt Dickerson was. And it reflects everything about his person, the way that he plays music. Now, this piece of music, Good Earth, is actually a relatively straight-ahead tune for the repertoire that Dickerson liked to play. This is one of his earliest records. This album, A Sense of Direction, his second record, he starts already to depart from playing straight-ahead tunes and playing standards. And he gets more into the very exploratory aspects of harmony. This particular tune is actually the AABA structure. I don't know if you picked that out, but the A section is basically D flat major 6. And then we have like this E half diminished with the 11th. I think the second time the bass player just plays a C, so that E half diminished becomes a C7. And that's the entire A section. And then that happens for 16 bars, and then the bridge is just C minor to D minor. And then we're back to strange to have this half diminished chord that does not actually turn into a 2-5-1 progression. And the way that he's playing harmony over the top of it, I mean, let's go back and see if we can just check some moments of it. It's just the E. Actually, it's just the just goes to the E. So it's D flat major, E half diminished. And now the bridge. C minor, D minor, C minor, D minor. And last A section. Really simple tune. Alright, now the solo. So one of the other things that Dickerson mentioned in this interview that I read, he was influenced very greatly by two people, Art Tatum and John Coltrane. John Coltrane was actually a childhood friend of Dickerson's, and I see a very strong connection between, especially Coltrane's soprano playing, maybe it's just because of the high pitch of the vibraphone, but Coltrane's extremely fast lines, the so-called sheets of sound. I mean, that's what Dickerson is trying to do on the vibraphone here. You get these long runs and everything is played at breakneck tempo, but it's not played in a way where it hits you over the head with a hammer. It's very smooth and languid, and it sounds really like the fluidity of Coltrane's soprano saxophone, for example, on My Favorite Things, or that classic record where he plays Summertime, and he's just playing all this upper structure harmonic material, but it sounds smooth as anything because of the way it's delivered. So yeah, let's listen to the next chorus. Bridge. I figured something out. Oh my gosh, he's playing C minor. So he's just playing fourths, but he's chromatically connecting them. That's a pretty cool thing. So it's D flat major, but he's playing D flat Lydian, I guess. And then C9. Can't play fast enough to do it. I hear sort of an F sharp augmented triad sound in there somewhere. Let's go back and figure out. I'm already lost in the tune. Where were we? That's the A section. Something like that. That's cool. So he's taking this voicing and this voicing and playing off them. Come on! I'm not gonna try to figure that out. This is the bridge. A second. That sounded like bebop to me. Listen to that line. That's a bebop line. Alright, so that line, I told you it sounds like bebop. I just spent like 20 minutes trying to figure it out, and all I could figure out is this much. There's bebop stuff in there, but it's... something like this. So we have C minor. Then we have G harmonic minor. Passing tone to the third, and then... this, I don't know how you classify that. He's really just kind of playing on the E half diminished at that point. That line's cool, though. Another similar line. Here's the bridge. Playing C Dorian there. The shapes are incredible, and then those lines that have all this chromaticism built in, it's kind of like C minor with a sharp 11 and a passing tone to the 7th. Chord. I hope this sends you down a Walt Dickerson rabbit hole. Be prepared to listen to a lot of music in the dark with just headphones. I feel like that's the best way. Anyway, thank you for watching.